On the last day of the Gujarat election campaign, Prime Minister Narendra Modi making a big splash on the Sabarmati River by landing on a seaplane. Joining us now is Union Transport Minister Nitin Gadkari, who's been a passionate advocate for increasing the use of seaplanes in India. He's been working on this for many months now. Mr. Gadkari, welcome to India today. Can you begin by explaining to us the rationale behind Prime Minister Narendra Modi landing on the Sabarmati on the last day of the election campaign in a seaplane? What's the message that's being sent today?
First of all, under the leadership of Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji, our government has taken a decision to create good infrastructure in the country. Now, in the transport sector, we have already increased the road length in NHI, National Highway. Now the problem is that automobile traffic is grown by 22%. The result is now the traffic jam and pollutions are the problem. Now the idea is alternative transport mode, we can use seaplane. So the aviation ministry name it as a seaplane. My ministry in shipping and port, we name it as a flying boat. It is one and the same thing. Now we have more than 5 lakhs legs, the tanks and at the same dams are there. Even we have already taken decision to convert 111 rivers into waterways. So we can use that waterways for also for the seaplane. We can develop like airport, like water port, and there this transport can be possible. This plane is now presently having the capacity of 9, then there is the capacity up to 12, up to 18. We are planning for having the plane having capacity more than 50. And here this plane is MPBS, where it can also come on the sea at the same time on the runway, both. So it is of multi-purpose use. So we can develop a new transport sector which is going to encourage our tourism. For example, from a lake in Jaipur, Jhil in Jaipur, you can take ride up to Jhil in Udaipur. So this type of, all type of transport, even we are planning to take it in Ganga in Varanasi. And so I feel that it can create a good transport new mode for the people of India, and we are trying from last many days on this project. Today, actually 2 days before in Mumbai, we have taken the first flight. Actually, it's for the trial flight, and it is successful. Now the Prime Minister has already initiated, and he also taken a flight, and it is also proved to be successful. Now it opens the new transport in India. It's a great pleasure and pride for me that our dream is as early as possible, we will definitely fulfill the dream of the people of India by enjoying these seaplanes.
Mr. Gadkari, while of course you're trying to find a new visa for travel, question is about how economical this is, because that's one of the criticisms of the bulletproof bullet train model as well, that it's only for the rich. I was reading that one seaplane costs about $4 million. How much will it cost for the aam aadmi to travel on this seaplane? Is it affordable at all for the aam aadmi, Mr. Gadkari?
I feel that the cost will approximately come to 12 crore for 8 to 9 seater plane. And for more than 22 seater, it will come to 18 crores. So it's economically very viable. And the fuel, we are planning to use ethanol as a fuel in it. It is indigenous fuel. So already the Japanese company is already working on it. And already I have suggested them to start manufacturing in India, made in India and make in India, by which we can reduce the cost. Now the number of plane we require in India is more than 10,000, because there's a lot of demand from different states. So when the number is increased, again we can reduce the cost. So it can be really a game changer in the transport sector, and I feel that the cost will be less, and that will be very useful for the common people. They can use this transport mode.
What about the safety aspect of the seaplane, Mr. Gadkari? Lots of people questioning that the aircraft that the Prime Minister landed on was a single seater. Omar Abdullah, the former Chief Minister of Jammu and Kashmir, referred to the SPG manual, saying that this is a violation. How safe are these seaplanes?
Actually, this is a single engine plane, and I feel that today, up till now, there is no accident. Even if this is a very safe plane, you can take it on any land. We can take the landing of the plane there is possible. We need only 300 meter of runway for that. So you can take the plane into any farm or somewhere into any land. At the same time, in any water body, we can take the plane safely. So there is no risk, not at all any risk is there. And that's the reason that in the world, in USA, already in San Francisco, there is already the planes are using, the Canada, in Vancouver and other city they are using, even just like near to our nearest place, Maldives, they have 47 seaplanes. So I feel that it is not a big problem, it is a totally safe. And there is no problem, we will make the manual as far as the safety standards are concerned. But presently I feel that there is no problem, and the Prime Minister has taken a successful ride. I feel that it is to be a proven fact now that there is no risk in it.
How soon do you see the first commercial seaplanes fly in India? There are some reports of SpiceJet wanting to buy some seaplanes. When can the Aam Aadmi travel on one of these?
First of all, within 3 months, Aviation Ministry and my ministry with coordination will make the rules and regulation for that. And after that, we will definitely encourage the investor in India to start these services. Particularly the one of the company where you named the company, SpiceJet, they are also keenly interested to develop this type of transport and using seaplane. There are a lot of investors already, we will ready, and we will allow all the investors and new entrepreneurs in our country are encourage them, and we will support them and we will help them.
Finally, Minister, which are the cities, areas of India where you think seaplanes have the maximum potential? Where will they be most successful and why?
Anywhere the lake is there, land is there, the airstrip is there, it is multi-purpose, so there is no problem, we can take it to any tehsil, any district, anywhere, and there is no need for development of any infrastructure. From my ministry, for floating jetty and other arrangement, we are going to start a scheme by which we will see that the all infrastructure related to the water will be given to that water jetty and other thing will be from my ministry as a subsidy, and we are planning to work on that scheme. So it can be, you can take it in a hill area, you can take it in a sea. We have 200 private and minor ports, then 12 major ports, and by 111 rivers, that is 20,000 kilometer of length is available, by which we are going to plan to making of 2,000 river ports. At the same time, we have lakhs of lakes, and then dams, and a lot of different airstrips are available, the small airstrip, every can be used for that. It can be a game changer in the history of transport. And I feel that the Prime Minister has already giving a very proven example by his initiative. It will definitely going to help us to encourage the people and encourage the investor for this venture in India.
This indeed is a rather unique and interesting idea. It's being used in the battlefield of Gujarat, but the fact is we've got so many water bodies on which these seaplanes can land. And I've been to countries like Maldives where seaplanes are used very extensively, so there is no reason why these seaplanes can't be used in India. Let's see how soon the commercial launch of this seaplane service happens. The minister powering this idea, Nitin Gadkari, joining us on India Today. Thank you very much, sir. And best of luck with the seaplane. We hope to be riding on one of these soon. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Namaskar.